one planet, 7.3 billion people, only one you. Life offers us many opportunities and learning experiences. Are you ready to explore and discover this beautiful planet, the life and energy all around us, the spiritual world, and what is unseen, along with your own personal soul adventure? Mark Lanehart, the intuitive prospector, is the spiritual connection you have been prospecting for. Internationally known as a tested and professional clairvoyant medium and spiritual advisor, Mark's work as a metaphysical teacher, medical instructor, radio show host, inspirational writer, and hiking guide are here to help you on a journey of self-discovery, healing, inspiration, education, and a whole lot of spiritual awesomeness. Dare to dream, dare to explore, dare to live. For more information on Mark's spiritual practice in Seattle, Washington, please visit marklanehart.com or internet search The Intuitive Prospector.
Hey, good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, wherever you may be in this beautiful planet of ours. That's a new feature from Zoom. I actually have a voice that the recording has stopped. So good morning to you, Metaphysical Mocha Mondays, here on the Intuitive Prospector page. Good morning, I'm Mark Lanehart, the Intuitive Prospector. Hope that you'll join me this morning for a little bit of inspiration, encouragement, motivation to help you get your week started on the week ahead. Happy Memorial Day weekend. I hope that you are celebrating, but I hope that you are celebrating the root cause of why we do what we do on Memorial Day weekend, and that is to honor and to remember all that have served and died in all of our wars to establish democracy, freedom. I always remind people, as a veteran myself of 8 years in the U.S. Coast Guard, freedom is not free, guys. There's always, as you may well see in today's society, there is always a push for, to break democracy down, to go against democracy, to go against the Constitution. There's different mindsets out there, different ideologies, different beliefs. But today we honor those. Today we honor those that have served our country to allow us to have the freedoms that we enjoy today. And I think some of us take for granted at times. So I've got my Never Forget shirt on, my new shirt. For those of you that grew up with the floppy disk, it's opposite, floppy disk, VHS, cassette tape, my generation. That's what we're doing today. We're never forgetting, and we're honoring those that have served this great countries of our great country of ours. So I haven't had coffee yet, so I need some coffee. And so today I got a really inspirational message for you for the next 30 minutes. If you're new to the page, make sure to like, subscribe, share out, get on that notifications button, be a star sender, be a top fan, get your top fan badge. Because when we go into the Healing Cafe here in about 30 minutes, we are going to get into some Q&A, some questions, some spiritual chats. And I have one of my advanced students that's going to be joining me today on the platform in the Healing Cafe. Reg is going to be coming on and giving readings as well as kind of a special Memorial Day for today. So I'm looking forward to him joining. This will be his second time joining us here in the Healing Cafe. And he's a very up and coming psychic and medium, and really working hard to push his boundaries, really working hard to understand spiritualism and the connection to the spirit world and you know, the abilities that a lot of us have that we just choose not to embrace and to discover or to explore and discover through body, mind, and spirit. So grab your coffee, grab your tea. Let's move in to the magic of the moment. Cheers to you. Happy Memorial Day. Happy Monday to you. Make sure to share out the page. Love to have more people come in and join our community on Monday morning, just to set a tone, to set a space, and to set a vibration of positivity. My platforms, whether it's here on the Intuitive Prospector page, or my group page for my podcast show, Inspired Living Radio, or my open public page for Soul Adventures. If you have something you want to post on Soul Adventures, an event coming up, share some inspiration, share a Soul Adventure. So you've got Inspired Living Radio, Soul Adventures, the Intuitive Prospector page, and then I have a new page that's solely based on called Experience the Etheric, which is more of a focus on mediumship. So those are the four pages that are open to the public that you can join, subscribe, get on, and follow. Lots of good stuff that take place on those pages, lots of information, lots of metaphysics, mediumship, psychic, spiritualism, intuition, awareness. And today, we're going to be talking about a few things, because we kind of live in a crazy time, don't we? Today is June, right? June, or almost June. Tomorrow is June 1st. Today is Memorial Day, May 31st. And it just seems like as we've gone along in this year of 2021, it just seems like stuff's getting a little bit more crazier, a little bit more outlandish. It seems that society has branched into a world of facts and science and an alternative world of non-facts and anti-science. And, you know, we're starting to round the corner, like I said we would in May or June. In my prediction show, I said by May and June, with the vaccinations and following science, that we would start to round this corner of COVID. COVID will still be around in society until 2022, maybe even pockets of 2023, as this, you know, this is a very deadly pandemic. And, you know, I know some of the debates have been, you know, because I'm a certified healthcare provider, guys. I've been doing medicine, emergency medicine, and hospital medicine for over 25 years, and I'm still a certified healthcare provider today. Even though I come on here and I do my spiritual work and my metaphysics and my inspirations, I still work here locally at Harborview Medical Center here in Seattle, Washington. And I always, you know, try to promote science and technology and facts versus, you know, wearing your mask, social distancing, washing your hands, stuff that we learned after the first pandemic of 1918 taught us a lot after we came out of that pandemic. A lot of the medicine that we learned about then helped us today. And with the vaccinations going on, I know, you know, some people are anti-vax to the core, but there's actually a moral duty and a moral standard for community public health care to stop the spread of COVID. You know, people are like, I'm not going to get it. You know, I don't have to get it. And that's fine. You don't have to. But at the same time, are you really contributing to society to make society better? because there are times in history, for example, measles, polio, chickenpox, things that you probably were vaccinated at a young age that you don't know about. But there are times to stop the spread of a pandemic. And, you know, I've heard the argument where people say, well, it's just, you know, it's like the flu. You know, there's about 20 to 30,000 people that die a year from the flu. And that is true. There is a lot of people every year that get the flu because of spread. But we found that this year, this last year, there was hardly any flu-like symptoms because there was no spread. So when you use that type of debate, especially against me, this is usually something that is not mitigated. Flu season is usually not mitigated. Some people will get their shots. Nobody usually wears a mask, and still 30,000 people, you know, 20 to 30,000 people can pass into the spirit world. But this COVID virus was mitigated. It was literally, everybody was locked down. Everybody was isolated for 15 plus months, if not more. This was mitigated heavy, and it still killed over 500,000 people here in the United States and 3.5 million around the world so far. Those numbers aren't accurate. Those numbers aren't going to reflect, when this is all said and done, how many people. I have predicted closer to 6 million when it's all said and done globally around the planet that this pandemic would hit. And that's, again, that was mitigated. Could you imagine what the numbers would be if it was not mitigated or controlled with vaccinations, with mask wearing, with social distancing, without isolation? The first, you know, pandemic that we really got our eyes on was the great influenza flu of 1918 that lasted for 2 years. And it killed anywhere between 20 and 50 million. Again, they don't know the numbers because they didn't have the accurate records back then. And I'm sure even in today's society, we won't be accurate to a T, but we'll have a good benchmark for how many people. So, you know, I hope that you are getting vaccinated. I'm fully vaccinated now. I feel more comfortable. But the one thing I'm most comfortable with is I know that if I could, yes, I could still get COVID being vaccinated. This is that happened in my family. We saw it firsthand in my family. But I'm not going to transmute. I'm not going to pass on the virus to another family that might be vulnerable or have a family member that's vulnerable. So if the COVID gets me, I know that I'm probably not going to go to the hospital or be put onto a ventilator, because when you get COVID, it attacks quick. I may get some flu-like symptoms. I may get some fatigue, or I may get a little sick, or I may not get anything and just be asymptomatic. But I know that I'm doing my part in the community to stop the spread. And you don't have to get vaccinated for everything, but if there's any time in history to get vaccinated, this would be that time. So where I was going with this is, because we live in such a dynamic, divided society today, not only from the pandemic, what I've seen the last few years, from pandemics to politics, to wearing a mask, to not wearing a mask, to getting vaccinated, to not getting vaccinated, you know, we've even got debates on if, you know, these are facts and these are anti-facts or false facts, right? Or the sky is blue. No, the sky is red. No, the earth is flat. No, the earth is round. You know, with all of the crap that's out there, guys, you know, lean on what you're sourcing and what you're watching and what you're bringing in. There's that old saying, garbage in is garbage out. You know, just because somebody says it doesn't make it so, including myself. You know, you can always hold me accountable. You can always check my sourcing. But this last year, I've really had to weed the garden of people that I thought were my friends, or people who, you know, were my colleagues professionally, or people that, you know, were acting as, you know, light workers or spiritualists. And I found just the opposite, not from a place of judgment or opinion, but a place of observation and just realizing people I don't want to be associated with. And, you know, it comes down to standing up for what's right, a moral standard, a moral code. And again, there's another part of this population that seems to have anti-morals, or, you know, stand up for things that go against a moral standard, or go against the Constitution, or go against the rule of law. Even I've seen with some of the rhetoric and some of the propaganda that's now floating out there in our society. And tomorrow is June. This next month, we get the notification of what we know about aliens. I talked about this on the last episode, this little pale blue dot, which we call Earth, that's in a galaxy that's vast. And finally, our government is going to give us some acknowledgement. I'm not putting too much weight on this report that's coming out, this full disclosure report on what we know about aliens, UAPs, unidentified aerial phenomenons, or what we would call UFOs. They changed the name, but it's really UFOs and something that we've seen for years. But at least they're bringing it to an accountability or awareness, which I firmly believe in my predictions for the roaring 20s, this next decade, would set the tone for how we move into space capitalization, space exploration, space tourism, realization that there is something more intelligent than us, technology that surpasses us and defies the laws of physics and gravity. Again, I don't get into the whole concept of little green men. Just because you have technology doesn't mean a little green man is inside. That'd be cool if Grogu, showed up and Star Wars was a real universe in a galaxy far, far away. That would be totally cool. But it's more, to me, more like Star Trek, that kind of moving into the next evolution. And maybe we're at a point in our history where we have reached a new stepping stone of evolution with our consciousness, with our technology. I wouldn't say so much our behavior, because if I was a higher and more intelligent species looking at our planet, I'd be like, I don't think I want to go down there. Those people are freaking crazy. But what I'm saying is, always stand up for yourself. Stand up for yourself, because if you stand in truth, if you stand in what's right versus what's wrong, I always stand up for the Constitution. I had a lot of debates and had some friends that went away because they thought that I was choosing a political side this last 2 years. And I'm not into a political party because I'm a veteran, and today is Memorial Day. I took an oath to support our Constitution of the United States, which goes hand in hand with the rule of law, the Supreme Court, because we are a land of laws, you guys. And so I take that oath seriously to defend and honor the Constitution of the United States against enemies, foreign and domestic. And, there's a lot of people, never forget, there are a lot of people that have died to get this country established, because this country was established on first revolution and what the British monarchy at the time would look at, terrorism, if you think about it, sedition, tyranny, traitors, and those traitors became our founding fathers. And over the years, our democracy has survived and our democracy has grown and evolved. But I think in the last few years, you can see that it's freedom is not free and democracy is not easy. Democracy is meant to be having two political parties work together for the benefit of we the people. And what we're seeing with our system is not working. It's crumbling, the infrastructure, the parties. And it's very, very right on line what George Washington said in his farewell speech when he gave up power as our first president, that his biggest fear was that political factions would tear the country apart. And that's what we're watching on both sides. I see it on both sides. So there's power grabs. And at the end, maybe this is all part of where we're going into this next stage of our roaring 20s. And sometimes you have to stand up when you see something. I mean, they teach us when you see something that's wrong, say something. That should be no different than, supporting the rule of law, moral standards, treating other people as you like to be treated, getting away from systemic racism, bigotry, misogyny, anti-Semitic. Those are all that are lack a moral standard. And if we're supposed to say something, if we see something, that's the same thing with those categories. Somebody's breaking the law. Cop means citizen on patrol. You have a citizen duty to either call the police and have them step in as law enforcement officers, or to intercede if somebody's life is in danger. That's what a cop is, citizen on patrol. And it's the same thing with public health care. It's like getting vaccinated so you're not helping the spread and you're mitigating COVID so it can finally die and go away and we can learn from this pandemic and evolve. Because if you go back in history, every time we've had a great pandemic, we've evolved. Something has changed for society. And as we wind down this COVID, which has been, unfortunate, didn't have to go the way that it needed to. It shows you that leadership always matters in whatever industry you're in, whether it's the president, a corporation, local business, leadership always matters. But leadership is leading, but also following. And you can see from politics how it's put us in this pickle. And it's killed a lot of people. And there's going to be a lot of mourning in the years to come. For years, families that have been impacted. I've been impacted both personally, professionally, and have even lost a few friends and colleagues along the way because of COVID. But this is a point where, you got to just stand up and call it for what it is. If you see something, call it out. See something, say something. And today's message is about standing up for yourself, even in the face when people are going to either rally against you or people are going to stab you in the back or say bad things about you or gossip about you. It's always important to stand up for truth and what you believe in. And of course, the golden rule, paying it forward, treat others as you like to be treated yourself, and always helping out your fellow man, helping out your fellow neighbor. But when the thing that I realized in today's message about standing up for yourself or standing up for what's right in a moral code in the Constitution and the rule of law, is you're going to have people that are going to go against you and want to, you know, have Twitter wars or Facebook debates. I've kind of gotten away from all that these last few years. And, you know, but what it helped me to realize for myself is when you stand up for yourself, you know, your real friends, you don't lose real friends when you start standing up for yourself. And I saw that as well, because I have some friends that, you know, have completely different viewpoints of me, which is part of democracy, which is part of society, is the ability to have disagreements and see different perspectives. But just because I disagree with somebody doesn't mean that I hate them, that I don't, you know, necessarily want to be around them, but I don't hate them. I don't want to, you know, hurt them or harm them or anyway. And we've seen that where people have such an opinion that they're willing to, you know, cause violence. And violence is never the way, guys. Violence is actually a low form of intelligence. It's a form of ignorance. My family's been impacted by violence. We are victims of violent crimes, including a handgun murder. So I can speak from this from personal experiences and expertise. Violence is never the way, and we need to work together. But the one thing I noticed is I don't lose real friends when I stand up for something. You lose people that are abusers. You lose people that are manipulators. You lose people that are control freaks. You lose people that are narcissists. That is the one lesson that I can take away from this last year. You know, I always remind people, if somebody has the behavior and they always apologize for it, if they do it a million times and you keep, you know, apologizing for it and you stay within that, you know, that energy, then that's manipulation, because apology without changed behavior is a form of manipulation. Narcissistic behavior, I've seen a lot. I didn't really understand what narcissism and gaslighting was until this last year. Now I've seen it firsthand. And again, my real friends in life are the ones that are going to, you know, still like me and respect me, but maybe debate me. And that's where we need to move as a society, as a consciousness. We need to be able to have civil debates again without argument. Because if you come from a psychology approach, if we get into an argument, no side is hearing each other. In fact, the body actually shows from an anatomy and physiology standpoint, when you get your temper starts to rise or your voice tone gets elevated, your hearing actually dissipates. And one of the things that I've looked at this last year that I think that has really been interesting is we'll just use the political system and what it is right now. Because again, democracy has to have two political parties to have, you know, a voice for the majority and a voice for the minority. So think that the voice of the majority, which would be more of the Democratic side, is black ants. And the voice of the minority side, which is more the conservative side or the Republican side, would be red ants. So you have black ants and red ants. And if we go to nature, we know that if I take a whole bunch of Democrats and I take a whole bunch of Republicans and or black ants and red ants, and I put them into a container to where they have to coexist. They have to cohabitat, say, this jar. Nature shows us that two different species or two different ideologies can actually work together, that they can actually get something done and actually coexist without violence. But the point when you actually come in and you aggravate that jar, so if I come in and I've got this jar of black ants, Democrats, red ants, Republicans, all peaceful, working together, getting stuff done for we the people, because that's what democracy is. It's about we the people. They work for us. We don't work for them. If I'm to come in and shake that jar and then open the jar and let them out, nature shows us that those ants will literally try to kill each other to the death. The black ants will kill the red ants. The red ants will kill the black ants. And it wasn't because what they stand for and what they do is right or wrong. It's because they were aggravated by an external source. They were aggravated by me, who shook the jar and then dumped them out so they could fight. And this last year, as an observer, as a someone that doesn't believe in violence, and I've been threatened. I've literally had death threats against me on social media, if you can believe that, where I use my platforms for positivity. Certain energies have shaken that jar to get to where the ants are fighting. And I think if we can rise above that and we can evolve past that and realize that somebody is shaking the jar, whether, you know, your belief is the president, big corporations, big pharmaceuticals, lobbyists, you know, whatever your belief system is, look at the bigger picture of what is shaking that jar, because it's the shaking of the jar that's getting everybody not to work together, but actually pull each other apart. And the alternative to this is not a road that I would want to see. I've been talking for 2 years about some sort of culture war, ideology of war, even a mini civil war, based on if we don't change our behaviors and start working together and reach common ground in democracy and the Constitution and the rule of law, then our way of life will change. What we enjoy today on Memorial Day, to never forget those that have served and paid the ultimate sacrifice to enjoy the freedoms that we can have today, to, you know, have our First Amendment rights, have, you know, rights to bear arms, rights to a free and fair trial. These are all things that are liberties and rights for all men and women that are, you know, of citizenship here in the United States. So I would say start to observe what is shaking the jar and move past that and get to a point where we can start working together and see each other's differences, but also know that through differences and through through great pain comes consciousness. Through great struggles, the genius awakens, as it will. And it wouldn't surprise me if maybe the alien report that comes out tomorrow or next month, it's in June. I keep hearing June 1st, but I'm not putting any weight on that. Maybe this report will start to help us realize that we are smaller than what we think we are. We're not the universe doesn't circle around humans, and that maybe we're not as intelligent as we think that we are. That's a lot of ego in our society. And maybe this report will help us to realize that we can start working together to achieve a higher evolution, a higher technology, a higher exploration into the universe that is vast. That's what I see. I've called it the great coming together. And usually when I did this prediction starting 2 years ago with the alien prediction and full disclosure prediction, the great coming together, I wasn't sure what would be the catalyst, but it's usually something that's a big trigger that gets something for people to start thinking differently to have this great coming together. Because people are not just going to come together and play kumbaya because we're so divided right now. So there's going to be some sort of jar shaker. There's going to be some sort of agitator. There's going to be some sort of scenario that's going to get people to think differently and bring people together so we can move forward. And maybe that is, you know, full disclosure of technology and a species or an alien race that is ahead of us, that is observing us. And I say they've been observing us for years, guys, because I don't believe that they would travel all this way to destroy us. And maybe they haven't even traveled all this way. Maybe they're in the oceans. You know, there's so much of the ocean we don't understand. Or maybe they're in a different way of energy and frequency and vibration dimensionally. Start thinking bigger, start thinking broader, because again, did they travel all this way? And if they did, I hope it's not to destroy us, because that would be pretty, that wouldn't seem very high intelligence to me. And if they're observing us, that tells me that they're here to help us, because I think they would have taken us out as a society, as a species, when we reach nuclear capabilities, because nuclear weapons during the height of the 50s, after World War II, really had a lot of interactions with UAPs and UFOs. So, I don't know. It's going to be interesting to watch how this report unfolds. But, you know, I go back to what Carl Sagan said, you know, who is the famous astronomer who wrote the book Contact and then made the movie Contact. If you haven't seen Contact or The Arrival, for how first contact or disclosure, or how an alien communication would take place, I think along those two movies as more realistic science, mathematics, linguistics, communication. I'd even throw in, you know, Close Encounters of the Third Kind, written back in the 70s, that Spielberg turned into a movie, because it showed how we communicated via color and hand signals and sound versus actually speaking like this. So it just makes me wonder if sometimes these movies are written after actual events, because they're very detailed in how we would interact with something higher conscious, higher evolved than us. So Contact, Close Encounters of the Third Kind, which can be a little scary with the lights, totally get that, or The Arrival. Great movies and great perspective to prepare us for what's coming out this next month, that the Pentagon is going to have to disclose to Congress. They're going to have to disclose what they know and declassify information that's been classified for years. I'm excited about it. I'm not fearful about it, because I believe in what Carl Sagan said, is when we realize that we are not alone in the universe and we have full disclosure and we have had first contact, it'll make us look at ourselves with such tomfoolery. I'm not quoting him exactly, but pretty much we will look like a village of idiots because we're fighting amongst ourselves and killing each other for resources and for land. And this will hopefully unlock a door to help us to move to a higher way of thinking and to see us as human beings means, not as a different skin color, not as a different religion, not as, choosing who you love. Because to me, love is universal. Love doesn't have a label based on who you love or who loves you, what they look like, what they support. That's where I see this going. And again, some people that are watching this today will always, they always tell me that I'm crazy. But I always say some people call me crazy, other people call me for advice. And I see us moving forward in a big way where, this decade of our roaring 20s is going to be really paramount and a very big paradigm shift for consciousness and how humans see the world, because the alternative is not a place that I want to go to. I'm not a fear mongering. I don't believe in fear. For me, fear is false evidence appearing real. And I believe that we're more capable of going to a higher way of consciousness and thinking and evolution than degressing and devolving to go back to, wars and killing and violence and ignorance and false ideologies and false information. So stand up for yourself, because when you stand up for yourself, this is where you realize who your real friends are. And you realize that you start to lose people that may be abusers, manipulators, control freaks, narcissists. I recommend not having those type of people in your orbit, in your sphere of influence. And that's something that I've had to do this last year. And like I said, no opinion or judgment ever on anybody. It's just something I don't want to be associated with and don't want to be a part of. And I can always love people from a distance. So there's going to be forgiveness. It's going to also have to take place for us to move forward in this great coming together and for us to come all back to a table, which is a table is usually round and has different perspectives, so we can start achieving great things that we've already achieved thus far. And I believe that we can do even better. I mean, think about just technology. Think about the technology that we have today, right? Smartphones, iPhones, our technology. I grew up with this. I grew up with the cassette tape, the VHS tape, the floppy disk when computers first started. So never forget also applies not only to Memorial Day and those that have served and sacrificed and honored and gave the ultimate sacrifice to give us freedom, but it also remembers, never forget where we come from and how we have advanced and how we progressed, because I believe in us. I believe that we can do better. And I believe that the human race is going to ascend, maybe starting next month, maybe starting tomorrow, with information that finally discloses to us that we are not alone in the universe. So thanks for hanging out with me today. Thanks for being in the magic of the moment. I'm going to get us ready for the Healing Cafe. So if you have a question, if you want to come in and talk about what we're talking about today, about standing up for yourself, about UAPs, UFOs, full disclosure, first contact, the evolution of consciousness and spiritualism, we'll get ready for the Healing Cafe. I'm going to welcome my special guest, Regin, today. He's going to be giving assisting me with readings and giving readings as well. So get your questions ready. We'll be back here in just about 2 minutes. I got to get queued up for that. And again, thanks for hanging out with me. I hope you enjoyed Metaphysical Mocha Mondays. Again, it's the 30-minute inspirational show every Monday morning at 8 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, where we focus on encouragement, inspirations, motivations, and exploring and discovering to find that diamond within. So until our next soul adventure together, be kind, be caring, be compassionate, and most importantly, dare to dream, dare to explore, dare to live, and discover that diamond within. I'll see you next Monday, and we'll get ready for the Healing Cafe here in just about 2 minutes, and have a great rest of your day. All right, take care. Namaste.